There was a particular drill we had. It's actually a knife drill. Now, I won't show a lot of that here because YouTube has a problem with when you pull out a blade. This has applications in situations like competitions against the cage, that sort of thing. I had one of my viewers ask a question about that. So I'm going to base a series on that person's request, one of my viewers' requests, for tactics used against the cage. Now, a lot of our stuff is used in threat to life survival situations where we are in lots of different environments. We are against walls, we are in corners, we are under objects, we are in cars, we are in elevators. So we do a lot of training in all these different environments, and a lot of this is applicable actually to competition type training in the cage. One of the things that we came across here in our training today, because we were working a little bit of knife work training, minus the knife, simply because we had children and so forth in the area and we don't want to expose them to that type of situation. The mentality of the strike minus the blade is the same. The motion coming in is the same. How we deal with intercepting the actual motion path of the blade itself is the same. Her body, how she backs up, the impact, how she has to adapt to that is the same. The one thing that we're working, when we're working a double bladed attack, we typically will go here and we'll go up to another angle, or even start at a high angle and go to something else. And what occurred was there's a mentality that when you're defending on the high line like this, people will tend to put the elbow up. If you think about it this way, if she's got this arm up, if you think about this as being a nice lever, now this arm position like this will transfer this right down through here, and it's an upper body sway movement. There's no direct line down to the heel. So to counter that, and this came into play because when you're using force to strike on this and you're having to defend because you're actually trying to drive the blade in, because that's how we train, it's not, we're just patty cake in the air. We work to where we are trying to apply punch power with a blade, you know, that sort of thing. We're working towards moving bodies, and that's how we have to do this. So when she's got the arm up for defense, what happens is it transfers directly down there. So you can try this with your partners at home and things like that. With the elbow up like this, how easy it is for me to move her base. It's really something to think about. So when we have this extension, you can think about my line of attack, just driving and creating this line down to the ground, or this arc down to the ground. And it will directly affect the base on that level. So one thing to do to effectively minimize that is to drop the elbow and put it into play. What happens is, because the first one brought it down here and there went to an unsupported base, where this one is more directly connected right to the hip and center of gravity. So when you have a control that comes in, even if it's on the high line like this, but she has an elbow down position, the actual counter force she's able to apply and the stability in her base is assured, because we are now transferring this energy more directly to the hip and not to an upper body line like that. You'll feel it. The difference is palpable. It's quite. So she's going to keep tension in there, and I'm just going to push. She's going to keep tension and put the elbow down. A lot different. She has a completely different base structure, and it's something very simple from going to this to going to this. Now, if you're against the cage and things like that, you don't ever want to bring your elbow up like that. You always want to tuck it in. You always want to get underneath, just like in our pummeling drills, that sort of thing. Any wrestling pummeling drill, it's the same mechanic. You always want to bring that down. But we're also thinking life threat. we're working blades. We want to make sure all of this is protected, and one of the best ways to do that, elbow down position. So we're going to continue that in a series for the cage work so that people can see how we transition some of this stuff to the competition type training. So don't forget, we're in Germany. Check out Marco's site over at CoreJKD.de and for more information. And if you like this, please subscribe. We want to grow the channel as big as we can. And with your help, we can do that. Thank you. So that whole line. So we go from this line, take this path down to the ground, all the way down versus this. Good solid structure, lack of penetration into strike, and direct counterbalance effect on my body. It's so easy. It really is a huge difference. Elbow down, big difference. Who moves? I do. Oh yeah, good bicep hit. Good. Hit the nerve right. That's what we train anyway. Best of luck in your training.